Welcome everyone. Just double checking, yeah, my mic's on. Welcome everyone to the JDL5 MLG Pro League Division 1 playoffs. This is the lower bracket between xGame and basically unknown. Effing Mad's new team, he's got a couple of new players, he's still with Sokshka. But the winner of this, best of three, goes up against BBC to see who goes up to that MLG Pro League Division 1 and get their spot up there. Now, I'd like to introduce my co-caster. He was on last night, but I'm joined by him again. Slesh, how are you doing?
I'm doing quite well. I was a bit in a bit of a rush to get back home, but luckily we're in the game, so everything should be just peachy. Yeah.
Now this is the game. Goes. Yeah, yep. This was the team I was mentioning yesterday that likes to pick up lots of tanky heroes with the troll and treant and things like that. Basically unknown. They're not going for it this game though. I'm really quite surprised because I guess Brewmaster and Viper banned out, troll one of their key heroes. But they sort of went for this four-man melee, really tanky lineup, and then had the Treant as well. So they basically were unkillable.
Yeah, I have to admit that I haven't seen, I think, any of their games really. So I heavily rely on your knowledge for their game. I have no clue what they normally pick. I know it's basically the French stack that of players that have always, you know, played together for quite a long time. I mean, Fucking Mad and Sokshka using the tag of Paris.
Yeah.
And I do not know who Magoma and Mind Control are, though. There might be two new players that I don't know about, but Sexy Bamboo, of course, most people still know him from various TI participations.
Yeah, not too successful, but still, he was a participant. Mind Control is one of the original members of Basically Unknown. He was in Aftershock, sort of a Tier 2, Tier 3 European mixed team. Magoma, one of his teammates. But they were a team that actually came over to the UK, and I've met them in person, and they won one of our LANs. So there was, you know, a good 15 UK teams. They came in over from Europe and won the first place prize pool. So they're definitely a team that have been to LANs, can perform, but they've dropped a couple of players, brought in some star names pretty much with Effing Mad and Sexy Bambo, some old school players there, and they've been performing pretty well. But going up against xGame with Stalcat, Mantis, Reeves. Those three core players who have played together since the dawn of time, really. They've been on NextKZ for a long, long time before they became xGame, and now they've got Arise and Big Num standing in. That's a pretty strong squad.
Yeah, it's very similar to the album sheet squad we're seeing. It's just Stalcat and Reeves in it as well. I mean, Mantis was playing as a stand-in yesterday, and Arise as well, so, and Big Num, I believe. So there were like three of the players that we've already cussed last night.
Yeah.
Well, at the same time, something that's reminding me of last night is the draft from the Radiant side, because it looks, until now, the first four picks are exactly the ones that 4AAC picked yesterday.
Yeah, Void, Skyrath, Sand King, so that Sky, Sand King, roaming duo that can do a lot in the early game, the Faceless Void,
and
Mystic Flare, Chrono,
well.
And then the Queen of Pain, yeah.
Yeah, four of those heroes are exactly the one. They last picked the Broodmother, which I do not think is going to happen in this game, especially not against an Axe. So,
Axe and Magnus, yeah. And also the Wisp can keep that laner alive, so it's not really too great to keep harassing down with the Tether and Overcharge.
Yeah, I don't think they're even considering it. But they are lacking an offlaner, so...
There's still plenty of offlaners there in the pool, but that Faceless Void, Skyrath, Sand King, something that a lot of Chinese teams were running up until, what, 4 or 5 months ago? Those three heroes almost constantly first picked. Queen of Pain, not so much. She's started to see a little more limelight as of late. Since that ultimate change, now it goes through Magic Community. But the dire side, xGame, picking up Wisp, Axe, Magnus, Lion. So they've got Arise's Magnus. They've got Lion, which is like the favored support now. With a Hex, maxing Mana Drain. It's really strong.
And probably the hardest counter to Queen of Pain right now. It's so annoying if you play. You cannot, if you do not see the line, you can't go for kills, basically. You cannot blink in, just for fear that line is there somewhere. Because if you're blinking, you die. It's the same thing. And once Lion gets his blink dagger, he's the one who can initiate on you. And because of the zero cast time on Hex, it's kind of little you can do as Queen of Pain. Most of the time, it's just if you manage to get an Orchid before he gets anything, then... Yeah, you're set. But
you go hunting,
And then you go hunting, yeah.
But you will need a BKB as this Queen of Pain. Even though there's Berserker's Call and RP that go through it, the threat of that Hex, like you said, is always going to be there.
Yeah, I think the just too much lockdown overall, she's going to be forced to go for BKB eventually this game, I think. But we'll see. We'll see how the game goes. Hopefully she's going to, at least she should be winning the match at mid lane against Magnus. Mag, he's not going to suffer too much, but we all know what Queen of Pain can do to most melee heroes mid, and she just destroys most of them.
That's an interesting
Void. I think Offlane Void.
Yeah.
Might be, it's quite likely. Unless it's something completely funky, and we see, I don't know, they could go aggressive.
Aggressive trialing with a gyrocopter maxing rocket, maybe?
Maybe, but would you really leave the Void solo against an Axe?
Yeah, that's a good point. And maxing rocket on that roll one gyrocopter, not something you really want to do. You need that flat cannon.
I really think it's going to be an offlane Void. I think it's in safe lane gyrocopter. At least he deals quite nicely with the Axe.
But xGame have such a tanky lineup. Axe and Wraith King, how do you take them down? And basically Unknown will be relying heavily on that Chronosphere to land. Sand King with a blink, even with that, gyrocopter cooldown, Queen of Pain, that Sonic Wave, you need that initial lockdown to keep them in place so you can land all of these skills.
Yeah, at least Queen of Pain can, you know, it's one of the better heroes to kite around with, but then again, they have so much lockdown as well. So, and they do not really have natural four stuff carriers. I mean, probably the two supports eventually if they get a good start, but neither of the cores are heroes that like to go for four stuffs. And against a tanky lineup, I really think the two supports need to get something done in the early stages.
So you think that Sand King will not resort to staying in the jungle using Sandstorm, get an early blink, go moving around with a Skywrath Mage? But who do they focus down? Magnus with that skewer? You need level 2 on Skywrath. You need that initial level 2 or level 3 to actually find kills.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know if the Axe is going to try starting in lane or if he's going to start in the jungle, but I think prioritizing, at least ensuring two lanes being won, is very, very important. I don't think they can do much if they sent the Void off lane. He's just going to be sacrificed and trying to leech XP, basically, but that's about it. I think Wraith King, Wisp, probably top, and line roaming, maybe, Magnus mid. Well, since it's a Ryze playing Magnus, I just think he should be mid lane. It's just very uncommon to see him go to the off lane with his mag.
I wouldn't be too surprised to see the Wisp stay mid a little while for the Magnus, because like you said, the Queen of Pain dominates that lane. But if you've got a Wisp there, controlling the runes, stopping the Queen of Pain, blinking onto the rune spots to get them before the Magnus does, then the mag could have a pretty easy time harassing with those orbs as well. Just the fact that the Wisp is there as a defensive support initially, allowing Magnus to get a few more last hits, an earlier bottle than he really should be allowed to. It looks like they're going to go aggressive into the Radiant Jungle, try and secure that Bounty Rune at bot.
And it looks, since Bambo is the one who's playing the Void, it looks likely that he, and he's been giving him those over. That's going to be an offlane Void for sure. So it's going to be Soxia, I suppose. Yeah, Soxia on the gyrocopter, starting with the boots first, which is really nice for zoning as well. And you don't really know. I mean, maybe they're expecting xGame to even go aggressive try.
Well, you've got boots first on the Sand King as well, so you've got that initial movement speed to get the Burrow Strike. Then that Rocket Barrage does so much damage, level 1.
Yeah, doesn't mean that they do not have any sentries, though.
Yeah, very true. So that stacking and pulling might not be that easy. Soxia getting scouted out there, but he's got boots. He's not really going to get caught out, especially with Lion so far back. Starcat tethered up by the Wisp, but there's no opening stun, really. Mantis tries to get there with the Wraithfire Blast, but there's that Observer Ward.
I really think that he should have, at least, you know, he can try to tether the Wraith King, because he's the one with the initiation, and possibly try for kill. But they got what they wanted. They got the ward down, and basically Unknown, they're probably going to wait until Skywrath has enough gold to get the Sentry Ward, but since it was a whole team rotation, you don't really know exactly where it is. And on the Radiant, the dewarding process is always a bit more tedious than on the Dire side. It's essentially, you always need three Sentry Wards to completely get rid of every single possible ward spot.
The main one is, you cut down the tree here, tree, you place a Sentry in there, and that sort of covers Magic Bush, covers that one there, and covers that one there. But you need at least an additional one for the like million ward spots down here hiding around.
Indeed, yeah.
You definitely need a couple of sentries, and then obviously sometimes the offlaner comes and places another observer around here for rune warding and actually seeing where the supports are going. Reeves is looking towards mid lane, just harassing Mind Control out. So it's not the Wisp there, it's actually the Lion, doing quite a lot of damage to Mind Control, taking him down to half, and he's only got shared tangos. The Null looking for the extra last hits and harass onto the Magnus, getting shut down a bit.
That's kind of annoying. At the same time, you're also seeing the little buff to line, 7 more base damage, and it's already paying off. You know, it's making the hero a lot more viable. He's just a lot better for zoning overall. Top lane, we're going to see a stun on Sexy Bamboo, but he does have a time walk out. And I'm just going expended.
I'm watching Effingmad running around. He places a sentry down here first to try and scout that area. Then he goes in, places the second sentry there, but he's got to waste tangos. He's got to cut into trees to try and find where this observer ward is. He's not going for it.
He thinks at the other side.
No! No!
Oh, please. He's got one more tango. One more try, man.
Well, there's no other spot it could be, really. Where's he going? Come on. You know where it is. You know it's the... he's found it.
There we go.
He doesn't need to tango through.
You actually don't need to tango, exactly. You can actually go in. It's one of those spots that you can use for choke point jungling, in fact. So, you don't need to tango for that one.
What an
annoyance,
though.
You only need the one for the right. It is annoying, because he spent a lot of time. I mean, it's 1:30 already, so the first creep hole they're going to have is only running just now. And do they have a... They don't have a smoke either. So the fact that Axe is just starting in the jungle and abandoning in bot lane is a good decision, since he wouldn't have been able to get anything, and the two supports are still bound.
Yeah. And mid lane, that one rotation from the Lion, just harassing at mind control, Arise already has bottle before 2 minutes. Gets the first rune. Nice little invis up there, and Magoma on that Skyrath will get the bounty at bot. Is he holding that for the Queen of Pain? Because she's pretty far away from her bottle.
She is really far, because she had to ferry more tangos. She bought tangos and had them ferried over.
And with null first.
Yeah.
But how are we looking on these supports up on the dire side? Reeves, Big Num, just supporting Mantis, trying to deny as much as they can from Sexy Bambo.
Arise? You can't really go for a kill. If you would be level 4, you might try for it, but... Yeah.
Or just skewer into mind control, get a hit off, and then shockwave.
Yeah. But he's only level 3, so that wouldn't work. And
stun
now
onto
the
Sexy Bambo. Can they actually kill him? He's going to time walk away. He gets a bash onto Mantis. He's actually turning the damage around on him. And then comes the Skyrath. Magoma coming in, could cast a shot and the Arcane Orb. Did he get another bash here? He backtracks the Rage Fire Blast. Are you serious? But the tether keeping Mantis alive. Still going. The crit. The turnaround. Mantis finding that. Actually, Big Num finding the first blood. Now the Hex onto Skyrath. Reeves looking for more. But Magoma.
Nah, they can't really do anything. Mantis just already backed out. But still, I mean, he backtracked a hell of a lot with a level 1 backtrack there.
It's Sexy Bambo. Like, you have to expect it. He is the RNG king.
I haven't cast his games in such a long time now.
We were talking about him last night with his broodmother constantly picked.
That's true.
And now he's playing today as that Faceless Void. So Mind Control finally has that bottle, can start looking to control these runes and really put the pressure onto Arise.
Yeah, he's got... I mean, it's something that some players like to do on Queen of Pain, getting level 2 Shadow Strike if you're against a melee hero.
Yeah.
I mean, if it's against a ranged hero, then it's not too much point in it. I think the only other time where you go level 2 Shadow Strike is if you're solo safe lane and you're one-on-one against an offlaner, because the lane is so much longer, so you can chase longer.
Yeah, and the only really non-melee hero that you go for level 2 Shadow Strike on is against a TA, possibly.
Yeah.
Burn through the refraction.
Maybe, yeah, possibly.
But you need sentries.
You need sentries, exactly. It's already quite an annoyance. Most people just forget about it.
Arise and Starcat both looking for something here. Level 4 Axe, that's what? Level 1 Battle Hunger. Berserker Call onto Magoma. Skewer, Shockwave, surely going to finish him off here.
First blood, yeah.
Not first blood.
It's going to be first blood. Not first blood, yeah.
They already killed Sexy Bambo up on top lane.
Good point.
Mind Control and Effing Mad looking for more. Level 1 Burrow Strike. He's gone for level 2 in Sandstorm, so he is looking to stack the jungle up. Try and get that Blink Dagger. But that really does make you wonder, why did he go for Boots first?
It's something, I don't know, maybe he thought that he could go for a kill if Axe was on lane, so that's why he bought the Boots first, and then realized Axe isn't there, and then decided to, okay, fine, then I'm going to farm. It's just always, it's one of the more difficult decisions to make, really. So, I mean, it's Gyrocopter going for early phase Boots, no big surprise there, that Zoe Mask should be... for Ring of Aquila, I should imagine. While on the other hand, I think Wraith King is very common to go for Midas on a safe lane Wraith King.
Yeah, he goes for Boots, Stout Shield. The Boots allowing him to chase down this Faceless Void up on top lane, get that initiation if a Lion can't get there. And they've always got that tether movement speed as well. And Axe is looking towards that Blink Dagger, and...
Oh, top lane! They're gonna go for Bambo.
Don out onto the Faceless Void, the tether, the Earth Spike, he backtracks it. Magic Stick charges? Really? Are you serious? Cannot believe the luck on this.
Yeah, level 1 backtrack. Value. I know some players actually completely forego it because they think it's not worth it.
Yeah, exactly. I was just about to make that point. So many, especially we saw this from the Chinese scene when they started picking up that offlane Faceless Void just for the Chronosphere. They'd go max time lock just for the damage because they thought, okay, well, it doesn't really matter if I die up here. But when you're forcing xGame to expend so much time, mana, abilities, going for kills that they just miss out on, it's not only the fact that they've missed out on that golden experience, but it's a mental factor, thinking, well, if he's getting these backtracks, is it worth going on him again? Should we just keep our mana and try and go mid or something? Looks like that's what they're going to do.
Yeah, they have a Wisp, it's fine. Wisp with bottle, and they always get top rune control, so it's very little they can do about it. Still a bit surprised that Bamboo's hanging out on top. I know it's nice to leech for XP, but in that time that he's staying in the trees there, he could have already gone back to base and TP'd out again. It's not getting too much done, really.
The Hex onto Effing Mad here, Berserker's Call Skewer. They're gonna get the RP on him as well. Expend that for one kill. Last hit by Jason, but Mind Control. Here comes the cooldown from Gyrocopter. Landing on two. Arise and Starker in a little bit of trouble, but there's a TP out. Arise not fine at all. The Lion and the Magnus both go down. And the Radiant only lose the Sand King.
That was quite close in terms of the mana pool for the Queen of Pain. He just managed to get enough mana with that magic wand to finish Arise when he was TPing.
I was just about to say, he's perfectly fine, and then all of a sudden, Mind Control finding that burst of mana for the Sonic Wave. Starker, though, returning into the jungle. 1,200 away from the Blink Dagger. They did move the Gyrocopter up here, but it's not such a big deal, because that gives Skarath a little bit of level.
Yeah.
Pushing him towards level 6 is never a bad thing.
Gyro, have they had any stacks with the Gyrocopter? No, at least I'm not seeing any.
Sanking,
it's mostly just for the Sanking, yeah. But nobody's stacking Ancients or anything along those lines either, so... xGame rotate the Lying bot lane, he's level 4, so... Yeah, it's nice to get some XP, he's completely starved for gold though.
568 HP. If he gets caught by, you know, one stun, one slow, he's dead.
Yeah. Looks like they want to pull the lane back now, seeing the Lying in the lane.
Like, look at how scared he is. He places a sentry in case Unknown have an aggressive lane ward spotting him out, because one cooldown in this area could catch him off guard completely.
Yeah, as mentioned, he doesn't have any boots, so he's 290 movement speed. It's not very impressive. Probably gonna go for a stun, get two last hits. Okay, you only got one, but it doesn't mess too much.
So do you think Mind Control here goes for the Orchid? Just try and get that silence as early as possible up against Wisp and Lion? Because focusing the Wisp is pretty much the way to win teamfights against xGame. Make sure they don't have the relocate save. That overcharge with Tether is such an annoyance, keeping heroes like Axe and Wraith King alive. Wraith Fireblast onto Sexy Bambo, they're still going for the Starket, Berserker's Call, just about getting there, and now the Orbs Culling Blade, taking him down. Mind Control does TPN, a couple of others reacting as well, but they're just a little bit too slow.
Yeah, he can't really go in, he doesn't have ulti, ulti's still on cooldown. It's just, you know, level 1 Queen of Pain ulti, it's such a long cooldown, you can't really use it twice. So, I mean, they rotate, they force a TP, it's nice and all, but no biggie. Queen, I think, if you're having a good game, yes, but at the moment he is, but you never know how it's going to go. It's either Orchid first or Lincoln's first, I would say. I wouldn't go BKB first. You still need the duration for later, for sure.
It's one of those heroes where if you don't sort of go 4-0 or something in the first 10 minutes, you really can start to fall off. You need to keep the kills going. And when he's not going to have the farm available to go into the jungle, take stack camps or take a couple of camps on his way from lane to lane, then he's going to get starved because Gyro and Sand King both need that. Sexy Bambo and that Void will start to need some items later on in the game.
Yeah. Bambo's done an admirable job though because he's kept Mantis busy the whole time. So Mantis CS is actually not that impressive if you look at it. It's 43, so he's 20 CS behind the Gyrocopter.
Yeah, and Mantis hasn't left the lane. The Gyrocopter's left this lane a couple of times now.
Yeah, on the other hand, Mantis is a Midas, so, you know, he's kind of making up for it, and he's got 2 assists to his name. Still, he would wish he had higher CS.
We've got Relocate Blink Axe here. Are they going to prep for this? Because Big Num and Starket are standing right next to each other.
Yeah, it seems like it.
Just waiting for an opening somewhere, possibly? But who do they find? Where's their vision? Can they see anyone? Faceless Void is the only target that they can actually see.
And they can't really kill him, I don't think. What level is his call? It's only level 1 call now. I don't think they can kill him.
Well, they're still waiting around. They're not farming jungle, they're keeping their HP high. They want to go for this. The Wisp is signaling. They might not use Relocate here. They might just walk straight up to him with a Blink Axe.
They might. I'm still not sure. He's got 4 stick charges, and if he just, you know, backtracks one of the more important spells, like the Wraith Fire Blast or something...
Or if he backtracks Counter Helix. Actually, can you backtrack... Can you backtrack Counter Helix? I assume you can.
I think you can backtrack everything.
Yeah.
There's very little that you cannot backtrack.
It's sexy.
Is there anything that you cannot?
No, I don't think there is. And even when you're hexed, backtrack still keeps on going.
Yeah, which is just bullshit. It's such a bullshit ability. I hate it. I hate playing against boys. I hate it when I'm playing him. It doesn't matter. I just hate RNG heroes in general. But you know that.
I know that. RNG is not your friend.
Nah, not really.
The only hero I can get away with playing RNG-wise is Lone Druid, because I just say Entangle, and he gets that Entangle.
Magnus?
Yeah, I'm watching this. But who's he looking for? There are so many heroes down in bot lane. Does he go for the solo RP on the Sand King?
He wants to relocate, that's why he's pinging. He needs to relocate, I don't think he can solo kill him. So Sand King has a blink as well.
Yeah, so he could potentially escape from this. Maybe he's going to wait for the Sandstorm.
Oh, there we go. Relocate.
Berserker's Call catching in the Faceless Void. Chrono saving Effing Man. Now, this could be a massive turnaround. Stun the Wisp. They don't get the stun on the Wisp, but they do get the Epicenter with the cooldown. Going to try and take down a couple here. The damage is being pumped out onto the Axe. Now, the Sonic Wave finishing off the Magnus. Lion did go in the back end to that Faceless Void, chasing him down. But 3-0 exchange there.
Yeah, and the Wisp getting out on 10 HP, so that was incredibly close. Mind Control, I think that ulti was wasted, actually, but since it didn't hit anybody, and just he threw it out after Magnus was already dead. Doesn't matter too much, it's a nice turnaround, but, you know, it's kind of unfortunate for xGame, because they had no way of knowing that Bamba was in the vicinity, and they probably thought that Bamba was going back to base regening or something.
Yeah, he did a really weird movement, where he sort of felt they're going to get the stun on Sexy Bamba, and now he doesn't backtrack that one. Earthspike from the Lion, and Wisp taking another kill. But yeah, Sexy Bamba felt the pressure, realized there's no one on the map, and he sort of made this weird movement where he ran all the way down here, and then decided, huh, I'm going to go over here, maybe help out my teammate, maybe find a kill, push bot tower, something like that. And that was just the perfect timing.
I think it's a bit... Stalker's a bit over-eager. He's only level 7, level 8 now. He just popped level 8. But he needs higher levels in Berserker's Call, and they really need the lockdown, I think. Especially if you want to kill those elusive heroes like Void or Queen of Pain.
Yeah. Now that's an interesting choice from the Queen of Pain. This is going back really old school, when Queen of Pain used to be picked, and Necro.
Oh, top lane, he really wants that tower there.
Mind Control going in though, getting the Shadow Strike out. Bamba? The mana! Mantis has no mana left, he doesn't even pop his one charges! And now Reeves gets it turned around on him?
Mm-hmm.
Whoa. Mantis there had 7 one charges, the Wisp is going to relocate back in. They aren't going to go for this, the Skyrath's just there, ready and waiting. What is going on?
Oh, he's going to relocate back in, never mind. So he... what, he relocated in? Oh yeah, he did. So he solo relocated in, apparently, so...
Huh. Maybe he's trying to send that Wraith King back, I don't know.
Possibly, but that was kind of awkward, gotta say.
I just thought that the Wisp had relocated out back to base or something, and I was like, what? What's Queen of Pain casting her spells on?
Oh, Axe, they see the Axe, they have vision on him. The Axe might die there. He's concussive completely shot on his own. That's unfortunate.
If they've got that concussive shot, that ends up slow.
TP coming in, though. Yeah, Mantis is back in, and he still has ultimate.
Berserker's Call. Skyrath, what are you doing? Really far behind enemy lines.
Yeah, that's a dunk. It's kind of awkward. He was the one who wanted to set up the kill, but I think his team either wasn't looking, and then concussive missed, and they were unsure if they should still continue going or not. So the Necromorph choice is kind of nice. It's nice, especially if you can get it early against a Wraith King. But normally, well, as you already mentioned, he didn't bop his stick charges. I think he would have had enough mana there, and he has a Wisp on the side, so he shouldn't run out of mana that easily.
Yeah, I just don't think you expect it. The Necro has just been purchased, gets popped, use that mana burn. It's a little bit scary when you're a Wraith King and you think, hang on, wait, I'm dead here. Arise mid lane, get stunned up, Mystic Flare, and the ulti, the Sonic Wave from Mind Control. They don't need too much damage now to finish off Reeves. Do they want to dive this though? Blink from Every Mad, not even needed. The Queen of Pain goes forward. One more right click, and that's an easy double kill. Another stun back onto the Axe. Relocate in here from Big Numb and Mantis, trying to take down that Sand King, but not enough damage. Mind Control just keeps on hitting Mantis, loses most of his mana, but still has enough for that reincarnation. Now Big Numb going to relocate back, but can't take Mantis with him. Paris getting stunned up. Sokshka trying to get out, but gets Culling Bladed down by Starkid on the Axe.
And he wants to keep chasing, but his Blink is on cooldown, so Mind Control should be able to get out.
He's perfectly fine. So he loses
the
Gyrocopter. But that was worth it, surely.
You mean the buyback?
No, the fight from basically unknown there. They
they
got a pretty big XP and gold lead.
Yeah, that's true. That was definitely worth it. Hell yeah. It's especially fucking man on the Sand King making the plays. And it's very important. He's really, really farmed if you look at it. There's a support Sand King, Blink Arcane Boots, 600 gold, minute 15. That's very impressive. And it's essentially, I like the draft a lot. It's just having the Void and the Gyrocopter, so you have two potential cores going into the late game. That's a lot nicer. And minute 15, Necro 3, that's very scary. That's an incredibly fun Queen of Pain there.
Well, yeah, I was saying she needs to go sort of 4-0 in the first 10 minutes. 6-0, 15 minutes in. Pretty impressive score.
Yeah, that's, she's going to be a beast to take off. And the next end item most likely is going to be a defensive item. And then
BKB Lincoln's, is that necessary here, really? Because when you look at the Berserker's Call and the RP, there isn't too much you want to try and BKB through. I think Lincoln's might be a little bit more effective against the Hex and the Wraith Fire Blast.
Yeah, I think so. The only issue is it can be cancelled by Battle Hunger, but then again, X is such an awkward cast time that most of the time you can blink out before anything happens. So I would prefer Lincoln's personally. It's also nice for the sustain. Perseverance is one of the best sustain items.
Yeah, definitely. They've given Sexy Bamboo a lot of time on his bot lane. He's had that Gloves of Haste for the past 6 minutes or so. Looks like he's going into some kind of recovery bidus.
They're going in on Mantis, they know he doesn't have...
The relocate save though from the Wisp, taking him back about 1,000 range behind the tier 1. Did Arise just blink in? He's got no mana.
Yeah, he's got no mana.
He's getting burned down. The Necrorine is absolutely shredding him, and now Arise getting taken down. The Necrorine is still chasing. What's happening here? Chronosphere catching the two units, getting relocated back to their original position.
That was unfortunate.
Epicenter catching out Stalkat. Reeves has already fallen. The Lion taken down by the Scarath Mage and now sanking with a Sandstorm.
Yeah.
How much HP did Arise have? 150. Getting chased down by those Necro units.
They're going to get more kills.
There's Blade Mail on the Wraith King. So he's returning some damage. Yeah, Wisp does die.
And Sonic Wave, is he going to expend it?
No, there's no need. No reincarnation. 10 seconds on cooldown. So that Wraith King, who had about 2,000 gold 5 minutes ago, lost plenty of it, has decided to go back in for a Blade Mail. And now, is that going to be a BKB? A Maelstrom? What do you reckon with that Mithril Hammer?
It's probably a BKB, but I don't know. I'm not a big fan of the Blade Mail pickup. It's on a, well, position one Wraith King, really. I think it's probably more of a transitional item than anything, but still, not a big fan of it. It's, at the moment, they are heavily lacking damage. Like, Lion is completely underfarmed, so you cannot go offensive at all. And Magnus, Arise has been trying to find the kills the whole time, but he's been a bit over-eager, really. He spent a lot of time roaming across the map, not very successfully, and that's also why his farm's been stunted quite a lot. Sorry, blinking to the side shop or something, and I'm picking up arcane boots, but still, if you look at it, the Sanking has the same amount of farm, and even more.
Yeah, Arise, 5,000 net worth, even behind that jungle axe, not looking good at all. Goes to the shop, buys the arcanes, like you said, but we've got a smoke here from the Radiant. They're looking into the Dire Jungle, trying to find that axe. Or do they go top to try and find the Wisp and Wraith King?
Yeah, you can just kill him 2 times over. They know he's there.
They need to burn his mana through.
Yeah, he's relocating. But they know he's here. He found him.
Okay, really well played there by Soshka. Big RP catching two. Soshka and Magoma both skewered back. But here's the Sonic Wave. And the Chrono, not even coming from Sexy Bamboo. Not needed at all. Axe jumps in with the Berserker's Call. Gonna get another Culling Blade. Will he escape though? The Necro units on the front lines, and then Mind Control blinking forward way too much. And Reeves kills off that Necro Warrior, taking that pure damage to the face. Big dump.
Dignum being chased by fucking Mad, he's gotta die for sure as well. He's just waiting for his blink to not get cancelled.
Yep, doesn't want to get hit by the orbs. Blinks forward, there's the stun, just about catching Sandstorm. Does Big Numb die here though? It looks like he's gonna be able to escape. Just keep on going. He's got Urn Charge, turns it back around on fucking Mad. He's actually going to get a kill! No!
That's a pretty nice play there, but then again, Quap cleans up.
I thought that Urn Charge would be used defensively, and he tried to TP out or something, but he turns it back around, gets the orb hits onto the Sand King. Really well played by Big Num there.
Yeah, it was really, really nice. Nicely done. And the Gyrocopter joining in the fight, so it's kind of worth it, even before he gets his BKB. He has it now, he's going to TP back to base to pick it up. And he's going to be just fine. But Bamboo going back for Midas, just to be sure, you know, you can never be too sure. You don't want to throw away a lead unnecessarily. So, and they can afford it. They're winning fights even without him having too many items.
Yeah, and these small skirmishes that Basically Unknown have been taking, they're getting, you know, like 1,000 gold, then losing a couple of hundred, getting another 1,000 gold, losing a couple of hundred, but they're constantly getting that influx of gold. And all of a sudden, the last couple of minutes, they've gone skyrocketing up to about 8,000 gold lead.
Yeah, and the biggest point in this is just the tanking. It's the two supports. They do so much. They can solo kill cores, basically, or the two of them team up to kill a core quite handily and easily. And if you look at it, both of them are very close to four stars on themselves, and that's what I talked about. If you're playing against those big burly heroes, it's always nice to have some positional things. And if they would have been shut down, if the two supports wouldn't have had such a good game, then it could look different, and xGame could turn around a lot easier. But right now, it's not looking good for them.
Yeah, and how do they start to find kills? Because Queen of Pain nearly has that BKB. Necro 3 into BKB straight away. Solskjaer, yeah, BKB. How do they actually get kills? Because these two heroes aren't going to... Oh, bot lane. Epicenter, Barret Strike, taking down two. The RP is going to get cancelled. No one to target. Arise looking around for someone. Solo RP onto the sky after Queen of Pain. Do you have your ultimate? Get hexed up. She's got it off cooldown, though. Blink off cooldown in 1 second. Might be looking for this. Stun forward from Effing Mad. Onto Reeves. The Queen of Pain not going though. There we go. The blink forward, then the Sonic Wave.
Yeah, this is a big problem. As you already mentioned, he solo RP'd a support. I mean, it's something that you can do if you're going for smoke ganks and you know nobody else is there. But if you're already fighting, you cannot afford to like carelessly toss it out. I think he was a bit panicking, but at the moment, it's pretty much all over already for xGame. It's very little they can do. All three cores are farmed on the Radiant side.
As Arise, it's one of those situations where you blink forward and then the two supports split, so you can't get them both. Then you skewer to try and get one, then realize the Queen of Pain has blinked forward and pop Necro.
Not the stack. Please.
Oh no. That's all they had left.
Yeah,
they were 3 days from retirement.
Yeah, that's like one of the comeback mechanics, is you still have the ancient stack, but it's so much economical damage that they are doing right there. It's essentially a full tower, and you're denying the enemy a tower.
And now Arise has gone forward, Effing Mad with a stun, skewers him back, Sand King in a little bit of trouble here, and now Mind Control caught up in that Berserker Skull, but the BKB from Sokshka, call down, catching a bunch of them, turn it around onto xGame, and this is looking devastating. Another kill there, Ultra for Mind Control. Can he find the Rampage? Mantis has two lives left, it doesn't look like he can.
I'm pretty impressed by his play. As I said, I previously don't really know the player, but at least his Queen of Pain play has been stellar this game. So, absolutely no complaints. That's absolutely brilliant play so far. I don't think he's made any big mistakes at all.
No, like you mentioned early on the draft, he can't really blink forward aggressively too early on because of the disable and stuns from xGame. So he's always held it, walked forward, held that blink if there is an opening to finish someone off, and he knows that xGame can't turn around, then he's used it. But he's never been overzealous in his movements.
Yeah, and it's also good micro and necro units. He's constantly using the mana bomb quickly, so that's also always a good thing. TP mid lane to the tier 2 being cancelled there, and...
Mantis losing his mana to the necro units, that's so annoying!
And he's also taking the damage there. He's got reincarnate off, but you don't really want to pop it. Still, it's something that I've never been a big fan of risking core of it, and this game is kind of proving it. It's such a long time before you get online. You're essentially giving, I don't know, you're giving too much away, I think.
Yeah, that's why we kind of see usually with Wraith King roll 1, you go for the early Blink Dagger and just try and put the pressure on. You use him as their initiator, or you go for something like Midas into Maelstrom, then you can increase your farming speed, so you get those bigger items faster. But he's sort of gone middle of the road here and not gone for the farming hard carry, and he's not gone for that tanky initiator.
Yeah, I think they probably, the thought process was they don't need Blink since he has a Wisp, so like you're foregoing the mobility item and you don't really need to get too much DPS since you have Empower. But, you know, the early game is stunted. Most Magnus players do not really skill Empower that early, and even just level 1 Empower is kind of underwhelming anyway, so...
Yeah, it looks like Arise has actually foregone going level 3 and 4 Skewer to get level 3 and Empower.
Yeah. And it's not only the 4 step, but the Yule step. They're also quite nice. Is there anything particular that they need to... No, not really. They don't really have silences, but still...
When Axe jumps in, possibly, just take him out.
Yeah, it's got zero cast time, so that's a good thing.
And you can also stop the relocate back from Wisp.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Wraith King going straight for those Necro units, dropping pretty low though.
Oh, tower gonna get denied for mind control, nice play. And they go for the smoke, I mean, that's kind of awkward. It's in the middle of the creep wave. So they definitely know they're smoked.
That rage was pretty big though, like mind control in the creep wave, and they tried to do it behind the trees on the rest of the heroes. Unfortunately catching the Queen of Pain.
But Sexy Bubba is still smoked up, and they know they are currently at the ancient spot, so he might go for solo Chrono there on those two heroes.
Well, you guys, both of them big now going to be the target of choice. There's the Earth Spike, Sexy Bambo Hex Stop, and Mind Control going forward. Misses the Sonic Wave completely. The BKB from Mantis going on to Sexy Bambo. He's got that sustain. He can come back to life, but now he's got no BKB, no Blade Mail. What does he actually do here? The turnaround, the RP onto one, the movement from Sokshka, absolutely brilliant, dodging that RP, knowing that Arise was coming. They turn around and I'm going to take him down. Skewers up, just trying to survive a little bit longer. Shockwave not going to hit. Meanwhile, in the back end, Yule's onto the Wraith King, the relocate back from the Wisp, not going to be able to save him. And Effing Mad, blinking forward, catching two. They just keep on going.
They can. Sanking Gaming, what can I say?
Triple kill from Mind Control. This is going to be his ultra. No, oh, Battle no, Hunger.
I think he might die.
Oh, he's going to TP out. He's fine. He's going to survive.
Oh, that was close. Very ooh, nice play. 19-0.
Sokshka still going. The Shadow Strike on the Axe. He wants this kill. One hit. Berserker's cool. Dodge. RP. Oh, no, he doesn't have RP. Skewer trying to keep him alive. Sokshka, Epic Mad TPing out. What's even going on? Sokshka's here in the middle of the base. Going to find a triple kill onto this line. Two more hits onto the line. He's dead. One. Two. No! The magic stick. And he missed.
You missed that hill.
And now he's dead.
But yeah, whatever, you know. I probably would have done the same thing in the situation. I would have chased as well.
I'm in. I'm not leaving. I just have to go more in.
Yeah.
Sexy Bambo trying to put pressure onto this tier 3 tower. The Wisp tethering to a creep. Come on, overcharge that creep.
Bambo faking the time warp again. And he's going to go in now, though. Mind Control's there. And he gets a lucky bash. Doesn't matter. I don't think I've seen such a Queen of Pain performance in such a long time, actually. Reminding you of Mushi, even with that missed ultimate as well, kind of Mushi ultimate, you know, yeah. Destroying it. Yeah, performing incredibly well all game, and then you miss the Sonic Wave completely. It's something that Mushi's doing constantly.
And that's what you'll get remembered for. Like, you won't get remembered for the laning phase or winning the lane. Berserker's Call onto Sexy Bambo, but there's Yules. That's what I was saying. Just take him out. Can they actually keep Sexy Bambo alive? Looks like they just about can. Epicenter, Burrow Strike forward from Effing Mad, but Mantis comes in with a BKB Blade Mail. Mind Control gonna try and get that Shadow Strike, which is dodged by her eyes. But there's no follow-up. They can't keep going. The mobility from the Queen of Pain.
Yeah, and they already took Rax, and they got what they came for. So, a buyback from Bambo. That's such a Bambo thing to do, though.
Guys, you need my help? I come? I help? Nope. We've already bailed on this. We got what we came for. Interesting that Roshan has not been touched, like, all game long.
Yeah. Well, they don't really need it. It's, most of the time, if the Raiden has a lineup that's not, you know, it's more gank heavy, and then they have more focus on gaining map control than getting Roshan, which I like, by the way. It's a good thing that they have in Mantis, mid lane, he's gonna get Boros Strike. Does he have his ultimate? Yeah, he has his ultimate up, so they're probably not gonna go for it. They have vision on Arise as well, and as well as on the Wisp, so they know everybody's behind the Wraith King.
Sexy Bambo could potentially turn around and Chrono here, but he just time walks away. The smoke, getting spotted by the Observer Ward, they know this happens.
Those smokes.
Sentry's placed, are they gonna go?
Oh, they see the axe, he's gonna get silenced. Does he have a BKB? No, he doesn't have a BKB. He is a Blade Mail.
Blade Mail kills the Skywrath and the axe doesn't die. Does Bambo go for the Chrono here? Yes, he does, on one. The Queen of Pain is already doing the damage in the back, though. Sonic Wave and the Shiva's onto that Wisp, and Bambo going for more. Boros Strike forward, catching two. Arise has the LP, he's gonna have to expend it here. Cancels, then reuses. Bambo skewered up into the high ground. Time Walk, how long until that comes off cooldown? Uses it to go forward onto Arise. One more nuke from the Queen of Pain. Triple kill again. 25-0. Mind Control. Absolutely amazing.
And he has a regen rune. Of course he has a regen rune. Who cares?
Axe buys back, tries to go for a kill, doesn't get in range for that Berserker's Call.
That's so unfortunate. But this Queen of Pain is so fat, holy crap. 29 minutes, 20k net worth. It's gonna get even more. This is complete domination right now.
Can xGame kill her? Like, is that possible? With the Shivas, she's got the armor, BKB magic immunity, she's got 2000 HP. You have to expend RP, Hex, Finger of Death, Berserker's Call, Culling Blade, just to kill one hero. Sure, it's gonna give you like 1200 gold or something, but...
I think they can kill her with Magnus, Wraith King, and Lion. Those three heroes should be enough.
Yeah.
And Wraith King needs a few lucky crits, and it's gonna be fine. But still, yeah. And Reaver. Okay, now it's getting a bit harder.
Reaver on the quad. Okay. Yeah.
2.5k and 25 armor. That's gonna be hard to chew through.
Mantis clearing up those observer walls that Radiant placed down. But they've still got Vision in the base. The creep wave at top pushing out. Arise has to keep this push back. Mantis even joining in there, so they've split. There's two heroes top.
There's no one hitting the Rex yet. So,
but there's the blink forward. Mystic Flare finishing him off. He's still got mana for his ulti though. He comes back to life. Who does he focus stun on? Tries to throw out on the Queen of Pain, who blinks away. Now Soshko with the Rocket Barrage. Flat Cannon turned on. The relocate forward? But who's he going to try and save? Gets no one at all. Mantis goes down during the Chrono. Stalcat, next target. But here's the big RP. Catches three. Culling Blade on 1-2. Borrow Strike Epicenter. Fucking mad. Taking them all down. Double kill for him. Big Num on the retreat. But Mind Control has his eyes on the prize.
Yeah.
How many buybacks do we see now? How many buybacks do we have? That's it. There's no buybacks left for the Dire. Wraith King in nothing 80 left. Gold. And it doesn't look like it matters too much.
You can feed the Quap a little bit more if you want to, I suppose.
And that's what the Quap's looking for, Shivas. He's found him.
He says ulti. He didn't use ulti in that fight. Is he going to go for it?
I don't know. He's looking. He's waiting. Lion is standing right there. Reeves.
I think he sees the wrist, but he doesn't. Does he see the line? I'm actually going to turn on the vision.
He was buying the heart recipe. So that's why he was there. He was selling magic stick or something. Bottle? I can't remember what he had in that last slot.
I think it was a bottle, but yeah. It doesn't matter too much. I mean, this xGame is still not tapping out. I don't know why. Probably still already thinking about the next game and just, you know, having a bit more time to think about what they should do. But I think the draft was nice and everything. Really good play for Mind Control overall. Although I think the Sano player is really been fucking mad. He's constantly getting two hero Borrow Strikes. He got his blink at a perfect timing.
Yeah.
And yeah, and he's really the one who's setting the pace in the game.
And you're saying they're thinking about game two, but it's one of these drafts from basically unknown where none of their heroes are really first ban worthy. It's just the cohesion of the draft itself is the strength. Maybe Faithless Void you look to ban out in the first stage or the second stage, but you don't actually want to ban out Quap or Gyro. Sand King is a possibility, is a pretty good second support.
Yeah.
But it's difficult for xGame to think about their next match and wonder what did we do wrong here, drafting-wise. Maybe they needed a bit more mobility, but I think it was more laning phase and item decisions that let them down.
I think the Wraith King was not a very good pick. Apart from it was fine. I think with Magnus opening, they're confident in the rise as Magnus, so it's fine. And the Axe is also, it's a common pick. Personally, I've never really valued, I still don't value the hero that much, that I think he should be first ban or first pick, but I mean, evidently most other teams don't think so right now. So I suppose X with Magnus opening is fine. Line to counter the Queen of Pain is also nice, and everything pairs quite nicely with the Wisp. And to get Lockdown, which you do not have with the Wisp, so it's okay. Oh, they found fucking mad, so he's probably gonna die. Although he has a BKB.
Oh no! The Chrono! Catching Mind Control, but here comes the Epicenter. Where did effing Mad actually go? Into the back, into the middle of three of them, catching Arise, Big Gnome, and Stalcat.
He caught four of them and he killed one. It's pretty impressive. Matt is critting quite a lot, really, but then again, Mind Control is still full HP and he hasn't used it. There you go, Sonic Wave being used. And finally, we see the RP coming out. They do kill the two supports, but then again, the three cores are still standing, so.
Wraith King buys back. GG's call, though. He gets a Yasha and thinks, okay, well, I'm going to buy an item, pad out my stats a little bit more.
it's always such a thing to do, right? Just before you go and call GG, quickly buy items so it looks nice on the scoreboard.
Of course. Yeah. But there's game one in this best of three between Basically Unknown and xGame in the playoffs for the MLG Pro League. The winner of this series goes up against BBC to see who goes through to that Division 1. We'll be back in a couple of minutes with game number two.